My name is Iris Franz, and today we're going to talk about Prisoner's Dilemma. So the Prisoner's Dilemma is a game played by two individuals. In our example, it's Alice and Bob. So Alice and Bob, they just met, and after they met, they commit a felony together. Afterwards, they were caught and put into two separate cells to be interrogated. Now, unbeknownst to them, FBI actually doesn't have enough evidence to get a conviction. So FBI will need Alice and Bob's cooperation, telling the truth, so the FBI will be able to get enough evidence and get a conviction. So usually we know what the FBI does is that, well, if you come cooperate with us and tell us the truth, we're going to reward you with a lighter sentence. That's what FBI usually does. So here is the deal. So FBI is going to tell Alice and Bob, so if you both remain silent, then you both get a sentence for 2 years. So 2 years for Alice and 2 years for Bob. And if you both confess, then 6 years for Alice and 6 years for Bob. And now I put negative because we know if you're behind the bar for 6 years, then your utility is -6. So what happens if Alice confess, cooperate with the FBI, but Bob remains silent? Then we're going to penalize Bob for not telling the truth, and Bob is going to be behind the bars for 10 years, whereas Alice can go free immediately. And what if it's the other way around? It's the same thing. If Bob confesses and Alice remains silent, then Alice will get a 10-year sentence, whereas Bob can go free immediately. So we call this payoff matrix. In this matrix, you can see the payoff for each player, meaning Alice and Bob. We call Alice the role player because Alice is going to choose between top row and bottom row. And we call Bob the column player because Bob is going to choose the left column or the right column. So how do we solve the game? What would each of them choose? Notice that they just met, so there's no mutual trust between them. And they are in separate cells, so they don't know what each other's doing. So to solve the game, you actually have to put yourself in either of the prisoner's shoes. So we start with Alice. Suppose you're Alice. Now, you're Alice, you have no control over Bob's choice. So you can only assume, given Bob does this, what do I want to do? And given Bob chooses this, what do I want to do? So we start with Bob remaining silent. So suppose Bob remains silent, and you're Alice. So I'm Alice. Do I choose to remain silent and get 2 years in prison? Or do I choose to confess and get 0 years in prison, given that Bob choose to remain silent? Well, obviously, going free immediately is better than being in prison for 2 years. So, given that Bob remains silent, Alice would want to choose to confess. So, we underline here. What if Bob choose to confess? Then, given that Bob confesses, I'm Alice. If Alice choose to be silent, then, oh no, 10 years in prison, I don't want that, right? But given that he confesses, if I also confess, I only get 6 years in prison. So 6 years in prison is better than 10 years in prison. So Alice will again choose to confess, given Bob chooses to confess. So we call this dominant strategy for Alice, because it doesn't matter what Bob does. Confess is always a better choice for Alice, given that Bob remains silent, 0 years better than 2 years. So Alice would choose to confess. And given Bob confesses, 6 years is better than 10 years in prison. So Alice will still choose to confess. So confess is a dominant strategy for Alice. So what about Bob? It's actually exactly the same. This game is symmetric. So Bob is looking at exactly the same matrix as Alice. Given that Alice remains silent, I'm Bob. What would I choose? I can choose either to remain silent and get 2 years in prison, or I can choose to confess and get 0 years in prison, go free right away. So 0 years in prison is better than 2 years in prison. So Bob would choose to confess, given that Alice remains silent. What if Alice chooses to confess? Then if Bob chooses to remain silent, Bob will get 10 years in prison. If Bob chooses to confess, Bob will get 6 years in prison. So 6 years is better than 10 years in prison. So Bob would choose to confess. So Bob also has a dominant strategy, that is to confess, meaning Bob doesn't care what Alice chooses. Bob will always choose to confess because confessing is always a better strategy for Bob. So now you know that they will both end up choosing confess. So the equilibrium is confess, confess, meaning Alice will choose to confess and Bob will also choose to confess. And I'm going to use a red pen to indicate the second choice belongs to Bob. So equilibrium is a pair of strategies, meaning their choice. Equilibrium is not going to be -6, -6, because -6 is a payoff given the strategies of the two players. And the outcome is actually inefficient because both of the prisoners could do better if they both remain silent, but that's not what they would do. Why not? So suppose they had agreement before they were caught. They said, if we're caught, we're both going to remain silent. But now, after we're caught, they're in separate cells. And remember, they don't have mutual trust to each other. So Alice will think, if I keep my promise and remain silent, and Bob also keeps his promise and remains silent, then we both get 2 years. And Alice doesn't care about Bob. Alice only cares about herself. Now, if Alice reneged on her promise and then confessed to the FBI, given that Bob keeps his promise, then Alice can go free right away. So Alice has no incentive to keep the promise. Alice will want to confess. Same as Bob. Bob also has no incentive to keep the promise, because if he confesses and reneges the promise, Bob can go free right away. So even though both prisoners can do better by both remaining silent, they're not going to keep the promise. They're going to break the promise and both end up confessing. And that's the reason why FBI, when they're interrogating people, they always put them in separate cells. So here is a prisoner's dilemma. I hope this helps and good luck with your studying.